Hey guys, Ivan here, and in this video we're comparing the six-time Mr. Olympia Dorian Yates versus 2019 new Mr. Olympia Brandon Curry. This whole, let's call it rivalry, between Dorian Yates and Brandon Curry started when Dorian Yates in an interview said that Brandon Curry was not conditioned enough and that he wouldn't place even in the top 6 during the 90s. Dorian Yates making this kind of comment didn't leave Brandon Curry silent, it did trigger him a little, so he gave a response, I think multiple times. He was always very elaborate and very calm about it, like he usually is, although his coach didn't really stay so calm when he posted this. Brandon's coach Abdullah got a little bit more triggered and he posted this photo. This is Dorian Yates when he won his first Mr. Olympia and Brandon Curry when he won his first and so far only Mr. Olympia. The caption says, "After you watch this picture, I want you to continue smoking all the stuff that you have been smoking, waiting for your response. Oh, never mind, you're irrelevant." That was what Abdullah said to Dorian Yates, who is basically the ultimate legend, the Mr. Olympia winner who actually turned bodybuilding to what it is today, who is solely responsible for the evolution of bodybuilding, solely responsible for what bodybuilding is today. So not a very smart thing to say to the legend, to the shadow, Mr. Dorian Yates, but I guess he was pissed because he was talking trash literally about Brandon and he said what he said. Anyways, guys, we're gonna compare these two bodybuilders, but no, we're not gonna use 1992 version of Dorian Yates because yeah, it is his first Mr. Olympia that he won and it's also Brandon Curry's first Mr. Olympia that he won in 2019, but guys, Dorian was only 29. When he won his first Mr. Olympia. Brandon right now is 36. Also, Brandon has been competing on the Mr. Olympia for the past, as far as I know, for the past 9 years. Dorian Yates first time showed up at the Mr. Olympia in 1991 and then the next year he won it. So 1992 would be the time that Dorian Yates showed up at the Mr. Olympia for the second time. So no, we are gonna use other years. First of all, Dorian Yates was not at his full potential in 1992. He was way too small. The very next year, Dorian came much, much bigger. And that's basically when the evolution of bodybuilding started. That's when Dorian Yates turned bodybuilding to what it is today. Before the 1993, bodybuilding was not what it is today. Guys were much smaller. So, we're gonna use the photos from 1993 till 1997 of Dorian Yates and of course the only version of Brandon Curry when he won the Mr. Olympia 2019, obviously. Also, it's not really easy to find photos of all the poses from only 1 year. It's basically impossible. So, I'm gonna use the photos with the highest quality from whichever year I find. So, let's get started. This is not an actual competition, obviously. This is just comparison. So we're not gonna use only the poses that are counted, that are scored. We're gonna use all the poses because we want to compare the physiques. Not only the poses, pose for pose, but the physiques themselves. So we start with the front legs pose, and even though it's not a pose that is scored, it gives us a nice perspective to what are the main differences between these two physiques. As far as the height ratio, Dorian was a couple of inches taller, so I'll try to make it as good as possible, but it's probably not gonna be 100% accurate. So let's go, let's just get into it, and as you can see, the first thing that pops to my eyes is they are basically the chest. So if you compare the chest, you can see that Dorian has a little bit more narrow type of chest, and Brandon's chest seems a little bit wider. Also, Brandon's chest seems fuller. Now the next thing that also seems fuller is biceps of Brandon, of course. Brandon definitely has much fuller and bigger arms. Not just biceps, but the triceps as well. And the same thing goes with his shoulders. What the guys of today have different than the guys of the 90s is the fullness. They are fuller, they're rounder, they're just bigger. Now, some guys like Dexter Jackson say that the judging criteria is different, that the judges today are looking more for the roundness and the fullness and the size than they are looking for the conditioning that was actually looked for in the 90s. But I disagree with this. I see what Dexter is trying to say, but if somebody like Dorian Yates came conditioned like this, he would not be ignored. I mean, he's huge. Sure, he's not as full as these guys, but with that size and that conditioning, he cannot be ignored. And also, Ronnie Coleman was very, very conditioned in the 1998, 1999. He was not as conditioned as Dorian was or the other guys throughout the 90s. But he was very, very conditioned as well, unlike these guys of today, unlike 2019 Mr. Olympia guys. Also, Dexter said that during the 90s almost nobody had shredded glutes. Which is also very debatable and it's probably a topic for another video. As for now, let's stick with this, with what we have and what we can see right now. So the next thing that pops to my eyes is the lats. The lats on Dorian are much low inserted and they just look much bigger, which creates better V-taper. Also, Dorian's posture looks better because he's leaned backwards, unlike Brandon, who is leaned forward, which makes him look a little bit freakier, a little bit bigger to the upper body, but the silhouette on Dorian looks better. As for now, the upper body basically looks better on Brandon. Yeah, he looks fuller and bigger and rounder, and you need to give him that, even though Dorian's silhouette looks better. Now we come to legs, and in this pose you cannot really see much of a difference, but you would know that Dorian had much better legs if they stood next to one another. He would just dwarf him in the leg department. Dorian's legs were world-class, huge legs, and Brandon's legs are just not the best legs ever, let's just put it mildly. And the inner part of his legs is very well developed, because he was aware that's the only part of the legs he can actually grow, so he did work on that, and he made better illusion, making his legs look bigger. But if we talk about the outer sweep and the just overall quad development, Dorian most certainly has better legs. Oh, calves, yeah, too, but nobody really cares about calves. Let's go with the next pose. Alright, so not the 1993 version of Dorian Yates, because his bicep is obviously torn here. It would be a little bit unfair to use the best version of Dorian Yates in every single pose, 1993, that being the best version of Dorian Yates, obviously. But this one is a little bit later, I'm not sure exactly which year, you guys can tell me. It could be 1997, because the background seems familiar to me, and that tricep also doesn't look very good. And his waist is definitely much thicker here, so Dorian is here definitely not at his best, but this is the best quality photo that I could find. And also Dorian, even at his prime, he was never good, very very good at this pose. So, let's compare them, and if you take a look at their arms, just a huge difference, a huge, huge difference. Brandon is much, much better. Then you take a look at their lats, and waist to lat ratio, the overall shape, the silhouette, Brandon is better as well. The abs, the waist, the chest as well, the fullness of the chest, overall upper body in this pose, won by Brandon very, very easily. As far as legs, Dorian's legs look bigger, but are they as detailed as Brandon's? Well, not really. Brandon's legs look more detailed here, and the way that he's posing with them also looks better. Obviously, the size difference is noticeable. Dorian's legs are much bigger, much fuller, and the calves are much bigger. But the overall flow of the legs compared to the upper body, I would go with Brandon here, actually. And this is the exact photo that Dorian was commenting on when he said that this physique wouldn't place in the top 6 during the 90s. Let's go with the next pose. Alright, so here we come to the side chest pose. And guys, you know that Dorian never really had super dominated full chest or arms. You know, his biceps and triceps were never his strongest part. Unlike Brandon. Brandon's chest is very, very strong body part. His biceps and overall arms are very big and full. And his weakness were legs, but from the sides it was never really noticeable. And you can really tell in this comparison. So as you can see, Brandon's legs are not looking smaller than Dorian's. And his upper body is looking fuller. But here you can actually see that difference in conditioning. Dorian's chest is just much more separated, the vascularity through the arms and shoulders and chest as well, and the side of his legs is looking much, much sharper, Dorian's, I mean, of course. So basically the overall pose, I mean, you can go either way, depending on what you prefer. It's very hard to ignore Dorian's rock-hard conditioning, but it's probably even harder to ignore Brandon's fullness. And considering the judging criteria of today, it would be harder for Dorian to place high, but considering the judging criteria back in the 90s, I guess it would be hard for Brandon, but I guess if you had a bodybuilder like this during the 90s, he would change the criteria. So, you guys be my guest, tell me who is better here. I would go with Brandon, I think. I think this fullness and the development, the completeness, is just too much to ignore. Alright, so here we come to the back relaxed pose, and here you can see a very, very noticeable difference in conditioning. You can definitely see it in the glutes, in the hamstrings, in the lower back, in the pretty much entire physique. The difference is huge. Dorian's back, one of the best backs ever. Brandon is also not lacking in that department, but he is not as good as Dorian, and he's not as conditioned, nowhere near as conditioned. So this pose, I don't even want to talk about it too much. I will just give it to Dorian, because it is very, very obvious. The development is there, but the conditioning is just overpowering Brandon's physique, because Dorian was crisp. He was so crisp. Just look at the hamstrings, the lower back, the glutes. Much, much more conditioned than Brandon's. Brandon looks fat. Straight fat right here. So he will be blown away by Dorian. Dorian was known for beating guys with his back. His back was just too good. It was insane. It was basically unbeatable. Brandon, on the other hand, has also an amazing back. But his glutes and his overall legs were just lacking in size, and it was very, very apparent in the back poses, especially in this pose right here. And you can see it in the hamstrings, in the glutes, and the quad sweep as well. His legs were definitely not big enough, too small compared to his upper body, so proportions were totally off. Good enough to win him 2019 Mr. Olympia, but to beat Dorian at his best, that's questionable, that's definitely questionable. So, let's proceed with answering that question. If you take a look at their backs, here you can see a huge difference in conditioning, a huge difference. Brandon has very good back, very developed back, but the conditioning is not even close. Look at those feathers, those striations, those small, tiny details. Dorian looks like he's made out of rock, like he was carved out of marble, literally, while Brandon looks very, very soft, very, very watery. Nowhere near the level of conditioning of Dorian Yates. So definitely this pose is won by Dorian so easily, so decisively. No need to discuss more about it, it's just so apparent when you just look at it. Alright, so we come to another back pose, and in my last video about Dorian Yates versus Brandon Curry, I just compared them in one pose, and it was back double bicep, which is probably the best pose of Dorian Yates. So in this video we're gonna go over the entire comparison, all the poses of these two guys, and let's go with the next one. Obviously right here, back lat spread. Who is better here? Well, again, the same thing I said before. In the back poses, Brandon cannot hide his legs. In the front poses, he can pose in different ways and create an illusion by showing his inner part of the thighs, making his legs look much bigger than they actually are, but from the back it's impossible. Here he cannot hide it. You can see his enormous back, but his legs are not up to par. Then you can look at Dorian, who is looking very proportionate, and his back is looking probably more developed, bigger, fuller, also more conditioned. The same thing goes with his glutes, way more conditioned, and the hamstrings as well. Let's not even talk about calves. So this pose also definitely won by Dorian Yates. Alright, so we are finished with back, but don't get too relaxed, Brandon Curry fans, you're not out of the woods yet. Here we have side tricep pose. Even though Dorian is not known for having the biggest arms, the biggest triceps, he was still very, very efficient at hitting this pose. So if you take a look at Brandon Curry right here, his arms are bigger, his arms are definitely fuller. The triceps are popping, the biceps are popping as well, which is not something you can notice on Dorian's arm, but the flow of it. The shoulder to bicep and tricep and forearm ratio on Dorian's arm, I don't know, I just prefer it. It just looks better to me. Brandon is tilting a little bit more forward, so he looks wider and his waist looks smaller. His stomach seems flatter, but Dorian's physique just speaks power. It just speaks power. It just looks very, very powerful. Now, if you take a look at their lower body, the legs are definitely much bigger than Dorian, and the way he's posing with them, with left leg behind like that, showing an amazing cal development and all this vascularity on his hamstrings, and hamstring development, and the calves on the right leg, and just take a look at those enormous quads. Brandon is hiding the lack in size, in quads, in legs overall here, in the side poses, but if he actually stood next to Dorian on the stage, it would be exposed, it would definitely be exposed. His legs would look much, much smaller than Dorian's. So overall, if you take a look at their chest and the shoulders and the arms, Brandon is looking fuller, But I just have the impression that Dorian looks better in this pose. I prefer Dorian. I don't know about you, but me personally, I prefer Dorian in this pose. Very, very powerful way to hit the side tricep, and with his physique, it looks insane. It looks crazy. Alright, so here we come to the abs and thighs pose. Thighs on Brandon are just looking way, way more inferior compared to Dorian's. The calves is just nothing worth speaking about. Just a huge difference. Dorian's calves are just one of the best calves in the history of the world. And the legs on Brandon are just looking much, much smaller, especially compared to Dorian. Then, if we talk about the abs themselves, Brandon was just off at the Mr. Olympia with conditioning. So he wasn't as conditioned as he was in a couple of shows before. So his stomach was definitely way blurry. Much, much more watery than usually. But this is what we got. This is from Mr. Olympia. So Dorian definitely has way more defined abs. Even though he was never known for having the most aesthetic and pleasing looking waist, his abs are obvious here. They're visible. Especially obliques. While Brandon's abs are nowhere to be found, covered with a film of water. And then you take a look at their lats as well, and you can see that Dorian's lats are just way more massive and low inserted, and his arms are looking very dominant in this pose, so this pose is won by Dorian very, very easily. Alright, so here we come to the most muscular, and I wasn't really able to find a good high quality photo of Dorian hitting it. I found this one from this angle, and I guess you would go with Brandon with this pose. I don't really like Brandon as well. Two reasons. First, rear delts are not as developed as they should be on Brandon. And the second reason would be the conditioning and the separation in the quads on Brandon. Not proper. And then you take a look at Dorian, whose quads are crazy looking. Arms and shoulders not as good as Brandon's, which is basically the necessity to be able to hit this pose properly. So I guess for that reason you would give it to Brandon because of the lack of the mass in the arms on Dorian, but the definition in the chest and in the quads would be on Dorian's side. So it's closer than what you would imagine, but I guess you would go with Brandon. But I think, in my personal opinion, it is very close, but objectively speaking, I guess you would go with Brandon rather than with Dorian. And so we are finishing this analysis, this comparison, with a front lat spread. Probably one of the best poses of Dorian Yates. And here, what you can notice, the first thing that pops to your eyes, I'm sure it pops to my eyes so bad, it's the legs. The size difference in the legs, the completeness, you know, the fullness. Look at the difference in the vastus medialis right there. The size difference is just huge, and not just size, but the conditioning as well, the details, the depth, the separation. A huge, huge difference. Then you take a look at upstairs, and maybe Brandon's waist may be a little bit smaller and tighter, and his arms also may be fuller, and his chest is definitely fuller, but the V-taper, you know, considering the legs and the lat mass, I would go with Dorian rather than Brandon. I mean, the fullness is definitely something you cannot ignore easily, but when you talk about completeness, anything else is really irrelevant. You need to be complete, first of all. So, Dorian was definitely way more complete bodybuilder than Brandon. Yeah, he wasn't exactly known for having super dominant arms. His chest is not on the fullness level of the guys of today. But the detail and the overall mass could just not be ignored. Sure, fullness is great, but when you compare it to size and crisp conditioning and super deep details, I would give it to details all day long. I give this pose as well to Dorian Yates. The only argument that you could make to say that Brandon would beat Dorian Yates is that fullness. But is fullness really that important? If somebody is as big as you, weighs pretty much the same as you, maybe a little bit lighter, but is also huge, more complete, doesn't have such a flaring and very bad weakness, such as not having great and big legs, not proportionate to the rest of your body, to your upper body, is that worse than lacking fullness? I think it is. I think the conditioning of Dorian Yates, combined with that size, could not be ignored and could not lose, really. I do think that the 90s were the pinnacle of bodybuilding, and I don't think any bodybuilder from today's era would be able to beat Dorian Yates. And we would have to go deeper into the analysis to try to figure out, would they be able to beat the top 6 guys? That's a topic for another video, but if we talk about Dorian Yates, I think he would be Mr. Olympia 2019 rather easily. With this kind of crisp conditioning, with that mass, with that completeness, and with that freak factor. What do you guys think? Do you think Dorian was better than Brandon, or do you think Brandon Curry is better Mr. Olympia than Dorian Yates? Whatever your take is, tell me down below, try to elaborate your comment, tell me what you think. So make sure to comment and like the video if you enjoyed it, of course. Please subscribe for more Mr. Olympia and all kinds of bodybuilding updates. Thank you very much guys for following my channel. All the best and bye bye.